Okay, students, I hope you are all well and healthy and ready to learn new things. So my name is Palak Patel. I'm working in the Mahatma Gandhi Institute of Technical Education and Research Center, Navsari, in Civil Engineering Department. I'm going to touch the subject is Building and Town Planning. The subject are in BE second year, SEM 3. Okay. So in this lecture, we will cover earthquake resisting building. So shall we start? First of all, we have to understand what is earthquake. Simple. Earthquake is a defined as a shaking of earth by nature or by man-made. Question arises, how earthquake occurs by nature and how earthquake occurs by man-made? Simple. By nature, by plate tectonic. By plate tectonic and volcano, and by man-made you can say by blast, okay, or mining, okay. So earthquake is very complex phenomenon of a load transfer, because you do not understand how the earthquake occurs. Okay, how the load transfer mechanism work while earthquake effect on a building. Sorry, and we cannot predict the exact time of occurrence, time duration and magnitude. We cannot predict this. You can predict the earthquake will effect occurs in a 2 to 3 years. Okay, you can predict this. But not predicted time duration and magnitude. You cannot say earthquake will affect tomorrow. Earthquake will occur tomorrow. Its time duration and in the morning. And this is the magnitude, like 7 or 8 magnitude. You cannot predict this. If you build a building for the 50 years, yet you cannot predict in the 50 years of building how many earthquake will be resisted by a building. You cannot predict this. Okay. The same two earthquake occurs, intraplate and interplate earthquake. Interplate means what? Interplate earthquake means it depends on more than one. More than one tectonic plates. Like at a border of the plates. When the earthquake mostly occurs due to relative movement of 7 tectonic plates. And intraplate means occurs due to movement inside any particular one plate. It's called intraplate earthquake. By the earthquake, India is divided in some seismic zones. Seismic zones. Zone 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. So by the color code, you can see there is a zone 2. Here is a zone 3. Here is a zone 4. How this zone distributed? Is zone distributed by frequency of earthquake as well as magnitude. Frequency of earthquake and magnitude. By these two complex calculations, your India is divided in four zones. Okay, means zone 5 is mostly frequent earthquake and magnitude is high. Zone 2 is less earthquake and magnitude will be low. Okay. Now we have the philosophy of earthquake resistance design. How to design an earthquake resistance building? It depends on some philosophy. Some philosophy, like look at here, you can read. An average annual about 800 earthquakes of magnitude 5 or 5.79 occurs in the world, while the numbers of only about 80 for magnitude 7 to 7.9. Means in a world, only 800 earthquakes which magnitude is 5 or 5.9. And in the 800 earthquakes, only 18 for magnitude 7 and 7.9. And these are all about annually earthquake in the world. So I am going to tell about India. India only once in a 500 years or even once in a 2000 years. For the chosen project site and itself will be only 50 to 100 years building life. 50 to 100 years building life. Okay, if I am going to construct a one building which lifespan is 100 years, but there is a magnitude which is 7 and 7.9 earthquake is did not affect in this 100 years, is did not occur in 100 years, because it's only once in a 500 years, only once in a 500 years. Talk about India. In India, there is a rare earthquake, 7 to 7.9 earthquake is called a rare earthquake. This earthquake is only once in a 500 years or even 2000 years. Okay. Now we have two types of earthquake resistance design. First is earthquake proof design and second one is earthquake resistance design. So what is earthquake proof? What is earthquake? Earthquake proof means design of building wherein there is no damage. There is no damage during the strong but rare earthquake. Shaking is called earthquake proof design. Means while a building resists a 7 or 7.9 7 or 7.9 earthquake at that time, building there is no damage in the building, no damage, thus doesn't any structural fail we can see in the earthquake proof design. Okay, but this type of design is too robust and too expensive. Simply we can say there is a too expensive construction for the earthquake proof design. But remember, building lifespan is 100 years and 7.9 or 8 or 8.9 earthquake is occurred only in once in a 500 years. So if you're going to design earthquake proof building at that time, your cost, your expensive will be worthless. It doesn't need to provide earthquake proof design. Because it's the rarest thing, 100 year lifespan, your building will not see any earthquake in their lifespan. Okay, so this phenomena is, this philosophy is cancer because it doesn't seem any useful. It's worthless. Right? Second one is earthquake resistance design. Earthquake resistant design means we have a three phenomena. Earthquake resistant design, we have a three conditions here. First, for the minor earthquake, like 2 or 3 or 4 magnitude. For the minor earthquake, there will be damage, but may sustainable repairable damage. It can be repaired or should not be damaged. By the minor earthquake, building member should not be damaged, or if damaged, then this damage will be repairable. These are the philosophy of earthquake resistance design. Okay. And for the moderate earthquake, if building resists a moderate earthquake, that time a repairable damage and even more damage then will be replaced after earthquake. Means the main members will be repairable damage, and other parts like wall or any other things that can be replaced. Moderate earthquake means 5 to 6.9. Okay, it's called a moderate earthquake. At a moderate earthquake, in the main members building, main members will be repairable damage, but we can repair it, and some portion will be replaced. And third, at a strong earthquake means 8 or 9 or 7 to 7.9. These are the magnitude which I write it here. 2 to 3 magnitude, 5 and 6.9 magnitude, 7 and 9 magnitude. So on the strong earthquake, there is a magnitude is here. The main member may sustain several damage or irreparable damage. Damage will not repair, but a building should not collapse. Okay. Why this thing happened? Why this? Building should not collapse. Why? Remember, there is an earthquake speed is in the 8 seconds. In the 8 seconds, earth reaches your building, and you got only 8 seconds to come out of the building. You have a run. You have only 8 seconds for the run. At that time, if building collapse, too many damages for the life, human life, animal life. At that time, if building will not collapse, you will get more time to run. Simple logic is there, okay? So these are the earthquake design philosophy. Now we have some general principles in construction of earthquake resistance building. Like some principle like lightness, simplicity, regularity, continuity, and size of building. We will discuss all things in detail. First is lightness. Lightness means building will not much heavier. Heavier structure means a large inertia force, and this inertia force collapse of this structure result in heavier damage and loss of lives. For the earthquake resistance building, we have a less weight of building. Okay, so building shall be as light as possible. Simple. Second one is symmetry. Imagine if building is not symmetry. Is your building floor, okay? You can see it's your building floor. Imagine a swing, which is a plank, is called a building floor, and here is a column. Rope is called as a column. Symmetricity means distribution of weight is the same all along the building. If distribution of load is changed, look at here, if this tile is at this place, load is higher at that time, swing will be front and back as well as twist. At same condition in the building. At the same condition in the building. If you imagine there is a building and load distribution is unequal. There is a shear wall at something, there is a load will be higher at that time. That portion, that place. At that time, building will be twist. At earthquake occurs, building will be twist. And this twisting moment will damage more. Okay, twist in a building causes different portion at the same floor level to move horizontally by a different amount. Irregularity of mass, strength and stiffness in a building can result in a significant torsion response. There, from the eccentricity in a building layout, where the center of mass and center of stiffness of a building does not coincide. Means in the building, center of mass will be here and center of stiffness will be here. At that time, we saw a twisting. Okay. Let's assume the swing. A swing with a tree trunk by means of ropes. Means a swing with a tree trunk by means of rope. The assumed trunk is a footing. Means a branch of a tree is called as a footing. Rope as a column. And the cradle means a swing plank is a floor. Okay. At a time, if we put a weight in the center and cradle and then we apply a load, it moves back and forth only in one way. If this plank, I applied a load in the center and give some force. So at a time, this will be only one moment, front and back. Okay. And then after the increment of cradles in the same as increase in the floor, lower floor will be oscillate less than the upper floor. The second, okay, here is a floor. You can see here is a ground floor, is a first floor, is the second floor. At that time, if we at the center, we provide all the load at the center and give a force to here. You can see ground floor, this upper plank, so less displacement compared to this one. Okay, so it means that if we increase the floor height or we increase the floor, the displacement of the above floor will be increasing. Displacement of the above floor is increasing. Right? And one more thing, assume person is sitting at a one edge. You can see here is a children, a kid is sit on the one edge. So load distribution is changed. Here we assume a load at the center, we assume a kid or a children is sit on the center. But at that time, child is sit on the one edge. The twist and front and back movement both we can see. Same phenomena is work in a building, right? And the last one is in symmetry. Assume it is okay. Our load is undistributed. Okay, in this time we assume a load is undistributed, but in this case we assume a branch is unequal height. Rope is unequal length. So assume our building is on a slopy ground and column distance is changed. Like, okay, at that time, if we provide a mass distribution is same, we provide a load in the center, but a same phenomena work here. Twisting and front and back movement both we can see. Okay, while an earthquake on slopy ground building column height is different, same as rope height is different, we can see a twist and front and back movement. Right, so these are the planning of symmetry. Second one is regularity. A building should have simple regular plan. It is intense, simple behave better during earthquake than complex. In the earthquake, we can see simple building behave better compared to these complex things. Okay. So in the regularity, we have provided a simple design of building, simple plan of building, like rectangular, square, or some pentagon. So neglect this type of shape L, T, E, H, U, and C in the building. Okay, it's called regularity. In the regularity, seen that during the earthquake, the building with re-entrance corner have suffered great damage. Separation of a large building into several blocks may require to be obtained symmetry and regularity of each block. For preventing hammer or pounding effect damage between block, of physical separation 30 to 40 mm throughout the height above the plinth level will be adequate, as well as practical of up to 3-story building. So what is regularity say? Regularity say, imagine these are the regular shape, but I am going to provide this shape. T-shape building. What we do? We do in the design plan this building in some parts, like here. This is L-shape building. But what we provide? We provide a block.
This is one block, here is a second block. Two blocks we provide. And this separation gap will be 30 mm or 40 mm. Why? Why this separation gap 30 mm and 40 mm? Because we will get by this condition, this gap, we found a bonding effect. For the reduce the bonding effect, we provide 30 to 40 mm gap. And in this condition, we follow the two principles. First is symmetricity and second one is regularity. Right? Second one is simplicity. With the functional queries, building should look aesthetically good, but that doesn't mean that we compromise earthquake resistance property of building. At some building, we provide aesthetic view, but aesthetic view sometimes compromise the earthquake resistance property of building. It's not a job of individual architect or civil engineer to plan an earthquake resistant design, but both have to plan it with all consideration. So earthquake resistant design is not an architecture duty or not a civil engineering duty, it's duty of both. Okay. Building with too long span, too large plan area, to a tall a building should be avoided. So building with a too long span or too large span area, too tall a building should be avoided. Okay, an earthquake is very complex phenomena of loading. Building with a load length but a short height can be collapse of crack in many places. Building with a long length but a short height can collapse of crack in many places. What do you mean by long length? Here the building is too long, here building is too tall, and here building is plan area is too high. This maintains simplicity, but in this condition your building will be collapsed or generating crack. Because stiffness is damaged here. Stiffness of building is will not follow here. Building height and width ratio should not exceed 4. This ratio is known as a slenderness ratio. Building height and width ratio should not exceed 4. Height and width ratio, and this ratio is called as slenderness ratio. And if we provide a too long or too tall building, like too tall building is not possible, if we provide too long building, we provide it a numbers of divisions, like we provide in the regularity. We can divide a building in some numbers of small units. Right? Next one is continuity. Continuity is important, most important. Earthquake force developed at a different floor level in a building need to be brought down along the height to the ground by a shortest path and deviation of discontinuity. This load transfer path result in poor performance in a building. Here we have one simple design concept, like how the load transfer mechanism work in a regular building. In a simple building, we can see load from the slab to beam to column and foundation. These are the simple load transfer mechanism. But while the earthquake occurs, load transfer mechanism is changed. Okay, it doesn't say that, but
it will be needed some shortest path, and some discontinuity it will damage a building. Okay, building that have fewer column or walls in a particular story or with unusual tall story tends to damage to columns which is initiated in that story. Look at here. These are the discontinuity here also. Here is also discontinuity. Here is also discontinuity. So it's called a discontinuity. Here is also discontinuity. Like at a time, what happened? Our load from the floor to the beam to the column, and this passed this way, okay? And at that portion, your load distribution is changed. Load distribution is changed because this column doesn't transfer a load on the ground. It transfers a load to the floor, beam, and once again. So this is called discontinuity. This will damage this floor. At same concept is work here. Same concept is working here. Floor to beam to column, and here is a discontinuity. What is discontinuity here? Look at here. Column is inside of the building. Look here. Here is a plan. Beam to column, and load it transfer like this. And that time, here is a discontinuity. At that time, this beam will be damaged. And same concepts here, column to column, and here is a found one discontinuity here. This load will be on the beam. At that time, this will be damaged. If we can say there is in the regular building is easy. It's so easy because we design like this. There is a beam, column, and then after two beam and column. This is a simple load transfer mechanism. But while occurs earthquake, this load transfer mechanism is suddenly changed. Load from the beam to column, and then after once again is a discontinuity. Like imagine there is a water flow from the here, and here is found some discontinuity. Here is doesn't find any simple way to the ground. At a time, this beam will be damaged. And same condition here. Here is a reinforced concrete wall. RCC wall. This is one against discontinuity. And this will be damaged the building. And many buildings. Look at here. How we find out? In the Surat, in the Bhuj, 2001, Gujarat. In the Gujarat 2001 earthquake, in the Gujarat Bhuj earthquake, many buildings with open ground story that will collapse or were severely damaged in the Bhuj. Design concept is same, but by the discontinuity building is collapse. Understood? What is continuity? Building on a sloping ground have unequal column height. We discussed this earlier. Unequal column height, twisting moment, damage in a shorter columns. And building and column that hang or float on a beam at an intermediate story and do not go all the way to the foundation have discontinuous in the load transfer path. These are the hanging or floating column. Here is the hanging or floating column. So load transfer mechanism has discontinuity. This discontinuity will damage a building. Then size of building. Building that is too long in a plan will be subjected to different earthquake moments simultaneously at two ends, leading to distributive stress.
Okay. Size of building. Look at here. If I am going to E shape building, we divide in the block. If Y shape, we divide in the block. L shape, T shape, and provides a separation. So size of building is matter. Not a too long, not a too high, not a too large area. Okay, this is called size of building. Okay. These are the practice question. Here is a practice question for everyone. Explain symmetry simplicity principles in a construction of earthquake resistance planning of buildings. Earthquake resistance planning of buildings. Okay. I hope you write this practice question and understand what is planning of building principles. Okay. Till then, bye bye.